Hi everyone, I'm Zana Fraillon and I'm the author of The Lost Soul Atlas. I'm absolutely thrilled and delighted that The Lost Soul Atlas has been shortlisted for this year's CBCA Awards. The Lost Soul Atlas is the story of a young boy, Twig. And at the very beginning of this story, Twig wakes up in the afterlife with only vague memories of how he died. And he has to choose between a blissful existence in the afterlife in which he remembers nothing of his time on Earth, or a dangerous journey through the afterlife to regain his memories and to try and find his missing dad. But if he fails, it will be as though Twig never ever existed. And as Twig journeys, we begin to find out just what happened in his life that led to his death, and Twig has to confront the choices he made in his life if he is to make it through. But can he ever be truly happy when his best friend remains alive and in danger? The Lost Soul Atlas is about kids who have fallen through the cracks, kids who don't have any adults looking after them or looking out for them, but they do have each other. And sometimes when you get rid of adults, that's when the best adventures can be had. And this book has all my favorite things in it. It has maps, it has riddles, it has a skeleton raven who is here with me. It has, what else does it have? It has gods, small little gods that have terrible little butterfly wings that can't quite properly lift them from the ground. It's got everything that I loved, and I put it all in this book. And it's funny because I didn't actually mean to write this book. I'd already started the book I was supposed to be writing, and then an image shuffled ever so slyly into my head. It was an image that didn't fit at all with the book I was supposed to be writing. It was an image of a small, scruffed kid stepping from the shadows with their hands outstretched, and they were saying to me, "Come with me. I can show you how to fly." And I couldn't resist. That was it. I stepped out of my old story and started to trail this character and this story. And soon I had found that I'd found myself so far into the realms of myth and folklore that I began to see signs and omens everywhere. I was hearing whispers where there should be no whispers. I saw shadows move when there was no light. I bought a magic eight ball. And I have to admit that so far, the advice it gives has been pretty excellent. And sometimes that is the best way to write a story. To allow yourself to be led, to throw all your plans out the window and just see where you end up. So thank you again to the CBCA for shortlisting my book, The Lost Soul Atlas, and I hope you enjoy it.